Hi, Libra. Welcome to your quantum entanglement reading with me, Jocelyn, the quantum queen. So let's dive in and see what's going on for you. These are going to be different readings, so just follow along. You'll see how they go. But this is for Libra's sun, moon, or rising. And as always, welcome to my cross watchers. Cross watcher, you could be dealing with a Libra, and the message could actually be for you. So feel free to take it however it resonates with you and your situation. Keep in mind that these are general and timeless readings, and if you guys would like to book a one-on-one reading with me, you can find my information down below in the description box. And just wanted to say thank you for liking, subscribing, and thank you for all the good karma donations. All right, Leaps, are you ready? Okay, so the two cards that popped out, let's talk about these two. You got the King of Cups and the Nine of Pentacles. So what I'm getting from this is you guys, you could be at a distance from someone, or it could be maybe you guys are in a little bit of quarantine with someone. It could be a water sign, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. It doesn't have to be, but you're possibly pulling away from them a little bit right now because something about the enmeshment or the emotional entanglement between you and another person triggered you in some way, shape, or form to go after your independence a little bit more. Like you're kind of detaching your energy a little bit. And I'm not gonna lie, Libra, like sometimes the King of Cups can be emotionally draining or emotionally manipulative. So let me dive into that. Hold on. Okay. Coming out, this is why. So you got the Devil card and the Reverie card, okay? I think what happened was, okay, some of you, if, for example, there's a couple of different scenarios I'm picking up on this, so bear with me, okay? If you are at a distance from someone right now, you could have started conjuring up, and this is your own shadow, because the Devil card, this is you. This is the overall energy of the spread. You could be dealing with someone else right now that is independent or independently free. Maybe even you're dealing with someone who has their own business, or they just have some type of freedom. And I feel like with the Reverie card, this is in your mind position, and this is all about imagination. So this is what I'm going to tell you guys. I think what happened was, for example, if you guys are obsessed with tarot readings, because the Devil card can be addictions, and there could be something that you're doing that you're pulling too much into your imagination about a certain person, either that they're going to come in and emotionally save you, or for some of you, you could be feeling like someone is emotionally free or they're very independent. And so you're imagining, like, say, for example, if this is a romantic interest that you're at a distance from and you can't be near them, you could be at this time conjuring up all of these things in your head about what's going on with them, about what they're doing. Like, for example, if this is romance, you could be thinking like, what if they're seeing someone else, or what if they're in quarantine with someone else? And it's a part of your shadow. That this shadow is the lower vibrational emotions of shame, guilt, and fear. So that's what you need to put more of an awareness on, is are your fantasies coming from a place of your lower energy or from a higher energy? Because it's all about your emotions and what you're creating inside of your energetic being, right? Their brain chemical releases. So yeah, what's happening? This is what I want to caution you on, because you've got the Four of Swords, and this is about meditation and calming yourself before anything. Because with the Eight of Wands, I feel like you could kind of impulsively communicate or reach out to someone based off of some type of illusion. And it's not a good one. With the Devil and the Reverie, is not the best kind of like imagination for you to come up with, because I feel like you've conjured up something, and there's more of this emphasis about you getting balanced within yourself and in your energy and get calm and stable emotionally before you communicate with people, because you might start becoming very reactive and just saying things. And it could be, for some of you, a part of your shadow could be that it's a part of your self-worth, okay? Let's be honest. Like the Devil card, there's something about you that you might feel even a lack of freedom or a lack of truly being independent, and that's really eating at you. And so there's something here where that's causing some lower energy and vibration within your being. And then it's conjuring up all of these illusions about what's going on with a person. And you could be, for some of you, possibly confusing it, that you're like, this is my intuition. This is totally what it's telling me. But it's not really, it's your shadow. Okay. I'm going to tell you guys that straight up. Because, and so what could be happening for you guys? Because over here, you've got the Death card, the King of Swords, and the Strength card. Some of you guys might, through this kind of illusion type of energy that you're conjuring up, you are, a lot of your fears are coming to the surface. And so because of that, there's your energy with the King of Swords. You could be like, and I love you guys, and I'm saying this because I have Libra in my chart, so don't freak out at me. I love you. And this, maybe this is the cross watcher, but Libras can be a bit dramatic, okay? Again, saying this with love. But you could start up some type of emotional drama or something because you have this fear of someone maybe like taking advantage of you or walking away from you. And so you might like try to put an end to this first with the Death card and the King of Swords. You might come from this lower energy of trying to like end something, and maybe you are meant to. That's not at all the meaning of this. Maybe for some of you, especially if you are dealing with someone that you have a very toxic addiction or a connection to that you're having a really hard time letting go of, it could also be because you guys became too emotionally enmeshed. And so this person, the cool thing about this Libra, this person is an energetic reflection of what you're going to be shifting into, okay? There's certain aspects of them that you really enjoy and that you're attracted to, and that's a part of where you are kind of energetically attracting two different sides of someone, your imagination part and your shadow part. And so the only thing that needs to be changed is the shadow part, moose, you know, pulling more into gratitude and love, because that's going to alchemize this and get you to where you want to be. Because yeah, look at this. Do you know what's fascinating? I feel like for some of you, you could be kind of resisting your healing, because this is in your fear position. You have the Star card, but I don't feel as much that you could be running a little bit from feeling the emotions of actually letting something go. Maybe it's accepting defeat. Maybe it's just actually approaching the heartbreak and understanding that this is over. But this is when the healing is going to take place, is when you don't run from or avoid these emotions that are wanting to come up to the surface for you to let go of. This will, because look at this, you've got the Death card, King of Swords, communication, possibly putting up boundaries, because like I said, King of Swords and the King of Cups, there could have been emotional enmeshment and more of a need of boundaries, not taking on the responsibility of other people's emotions and their happiness. You know, that's that codependency. So the World card, you're going through this, you're wanting to end a cycle, you're wanting to move forward, but I feel like just chemically and energetically, you're still tied to a certain pattern of behavior. If this isn't an actual person, for some of you, this can just be a behavior you have. You know, what? Oh, I actually heard this recently. Instead of thinking like, what are you searching for? What is stalking you? And some of you guys might have that. Like, I would ask yourself that question, because I just watched this woman's video and she posed that question and it really made me think. I was like, yeah, that's an interesting concept. So with the Five of Swords coming out in your mind, this is gaslighting. This is mind games, but sometimes you get sucked into it, Libra, because there's a part of you that still, and this is a part of your childhood programming where maybe you had a parent that always seemed like they were right or said they were right, or I'm the know-it-all, or and you would say, why does it have to be this way? And they would say, just because. And like, and there's so much connotation and underlying messages that come with just that. And so it made you question your own reality and your own intuition. So that's why sometimes you can get caught maybe in outside, like holographic relationship battles with certain people, or conflict of getting stuck in mind games, because it's like you're still energetically trying to prove something to someone that you're right. And I would take a look at that too, Libra. Like, what are you trying to prove? You don't have anything to prove to anyone. Just be okay with yourself, and you will shift out of this very quickly when you come to that realization. That's why I was saying that, because look what came out next. When you decide to walk away from the mind game, put down your sword, put down the game, you're going to feel victorious, because you're going to be like, oh, I don't have to fight for anything. And then you're going to come out of that and be moving forward victoriously. But this is all coming out in the mind. This is all what, oh man, Libra. So it's, you guys might have been in some type of cycle, right? With the Justice card of back and forth, right? The snake bites the hand, and then the hand cuts the snake. That's that karmic cycle of pain. So you could have been involved, and you've got two fives here, which is all about conflict. That's what you're moving away from. And as you do that, you'll be ending a cycle and feeling like you're coming out victorious finally. And look at your final outcome card, the Emperor card, which is Aries. This is your exact opposite energy, and truly stepping into your power. Really taking your power back by doing something opposite. That's the fascinating thing. You're not like... a part of you thinks, I have to mentally win this argument or this battle. But when you decide to let it go is when you will truly win. So interesting. Yeah, Five of Pentacles. When you take your power back, someone here, I feel, has been getting a lot of an energy drain from you. You'll be shutting them out in the cold. You'll be probably moving forward and rejecting them and be back in control of your energy. Okay. So yeah, I'm going to leave it there, Libra. I'm not going to do extended on these ones just for this week. We'll do them next week, but I hope you guys got something useful from it, and I will see you guys in your next reading. Take care.